Have you ever wondered where you really stand with God? Are you overcome with feelings of guilt because of things you've done wrong? Are you tired of religion that focuses on rules that you can't keep? Have we got good news for you? It's time to listen in on some casual conversation with Mike Kapler and Joel Brueseke and discover what true freedom is all about. This is Growing in Grace.
The Growing in Grace podcast with me, Mike Kapler, and that guy right over there, Joel Brueseke. Thank you for letting us know that you are out there. Growingingrace.org. You will find all of our past archived programs, and our special announcer, Joel Brueseke here, will now enlighten you on other ways in which you can find our podcast. Mr. Joel.
Oh, there's all kinds of ways. The main way, growingingrace.org. Like you said, that's just the best way. I think you said that. Did you say that?
I did say that. Okay. That's all I said.
I wasn't really listening to you, so I don't really know. But yeah, we're on Spotify these days, Google Podcasts, Apple Podcasts, Podbean, lots of different ways. It's all linked to there at growingingrace.org. So it's pretty cool to see how this podcast has evolved over the years, as far as, you know, it used to be just on an internet radio station, and then we started posting it solely to the website. I mean, I actually had, I posted the things to the website, and then now I'm actually hosting the files somewhere else, and they're posted on the blog on at growingingrace.org. So yeah, it's just really cool how this thing has come about. And by the way, we are rapidly approaching our 700 podcast. This is 699, and so next week we'll have something special for you to listen to. So we'll see how that goes next week. In the meantime, we had just the last couple of weeks talked about the idea of, is what a person is saying, is that biblical? Is this biblical? We have some doctrine, and we said, well, I can tell you that is biblical right there. And you could maybe find a few verses in the Bible that kind of make your case. But then someone else can find something else somewhere else that's perhaps a different covenant, and they say, well, that's biblical, but it kind of opposes what the other person says. So we talked a little bit about that. Go back to the last couple of podcasts and find out what we had to say about that. And this week, I think that what we're going to talk about, it's going to turn some heads. Because it's another catchphrase, you know, the catchphrase, well, this is biblical or isn't it biblical? Well, this one, we don't live by the Bible. A lot of religious heads will turn and gasp at that one, but we're going to talk about that this week and see where we get with this.
Hopefully after 700 programs, a lot of our listeners anyway, not all, because we always have new ones, which is a cool thing, by the way. Our audience seems to grow as far as downloads and listenership goes, even after all these years. So that's exciting that more people are finding out about us. I think our message has resonated, and maybe the way we deliver it has resonated with a lot of people who have been just kind of tired of the whole church thing. Just to clarify, we're not against the church or even church organizations, but I just think a lot of people have been hurt in many ways or misinformed about what the gospel is. And so they're finding out some things here through the podcast at growingingrace.org. And they're finding out some things that they hadn't really heard much about over the years. And it's bringing them into a new excitement with the Lord Jesus Christ. And so hopefully after 700 programs, where I'm going with this, is that you come to realize how much we rely upon the scriptures, also referred to as this book called the Bible. Now, you've heard us say this before, and I like to kind of relentlessly pursue this, and that is that the Bible isn't a book. The Bible is not just a book. It's alive. It's powerful, but it's made up of many books. It's made up of many books. And it's been written by a bunch of different people over a period of many years. And by the way, many things that could be considered scripture were not included in what we know of as the Bible here over the past several hundred years since it's been put together. Of course, the Bible wasn't written in chapters and verses, and even the names of the books and many other things sometimes have been added publishers came to a consensus on much of this. The Bible verses alone, there were a couple of different choices out there many centuries ago, like 6-7 centuries ago, something like that, where somebody had tried to create this way to be better reference things. And ultimately, it's kind of like technology sometimes, you know, one company is battling another company for who's going to win out, you know, who's going to win? Is it going to be Android cell phones or is it going to be Windows? I mean, you know, just different things over the years that we've seen change. And so it was kind of like that with Bible verses. Eventually, there was a subscribed method on how to determine which version of the Bible or the scriptures people would start using. All of that to say, I mean, there's things in your Bible that aren't actually scripture. There's notes, there's commentaries, there's cross references, there's the New Testament page, which we've talked about. There's all kinds of that sort of thing in there. And so the comment that you made, Joel, that we don't live by the Bible, so people can start to exhale now. The good news here is, we're not against the Bible. We rely upon the Bible. We search the scriptures and seek truth within those scriptures. We believe that all scripture is given by inspiration of God. It's profitable for us. It teaches us in God's righteousness. So don't panic here. Mm-hmm. But our life is found in something else. It's the person of Jesus Christ. And perhaps one passage that we can rely upon during this program is Jesus was talking to some Jewish people in John chapter 5. And he told them, he said, you know what? And I'll paraphrase here and say, you Jewish people, that's what he meant. He said, you search the scriptures because you think that in them you have eternal life. And it is they, the scriptures, that bear witness about me. Yet you refuse to come to me that you may have life. So, Joel, I think one of the problems we've had in modern day Christianity, especially in our culture, is that sometimes we have elevated the quote unquote good book above the person to whom the writings bear witness. So where do you want to go with that?
I mean, that's right. The words are written in books and they do testify. They do bear witness about Jesus. And like you said, we don't shun the Bible. We love having the Bible. We're glad that these scriptures have been written and that we can look to them to find out about God, to find out about Jesus, to find out about this life that Jesus came to give us. And at the same time, we understand that the scriptures themselves, the Bible itself, is not life. Jesus told those people, like you were saying, they search the scriptures. You know, like you said, it's okay to search the scriptures. We do that. But their problem was they thought that in the scriptures they would have life. If I have a good head knowledge of the scriptures, if I understand what the scriptures say, but that's not really where life is. These scriptures testify of him, but yet you've got to come to him if you want to have life. They weren't willing to come to him that they may have life, because in him, John says, right at the beginning of the book of John, John says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. It's talking about Jesus here. All things were made through him, and without him, nothing was made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And so in him, in Jesus Christ, not in the scriptures, not in words written on a page. Again, not taking away from the words written on a page, not taking away from the scriptures that testify, that bear witness to Jesus, not taking away from that at all. But our relationship is not with a Bible. Our relationship is not with the scriptures, but it's with the living God, Jesus Christ himself. Paul had said that he died. Paul said, I've been crucified with Christ. I no longer live. It is no longer I who live, but Christ lives in me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me and gave himself for me. That is where life is found. It's in him. That is how we live. There are a lot of people over the centuries who have not had access to the Bible like we have. And like you said, with all the headings and the subtitles and the chapters and the verses, the numbers that are all written in there, the notes that are in there, all of that stuff. There are many people who have not even had access to the scriptures themselves. And yet, anybody who believes in Jesus Christ can have life. The life comes by faith in him, not through faith in the knowledge of the scriptures.
Do you see what Joel just did there? He was using the Bible to try to tell you that it's not the Bible that gives us life. And that's how this works. Because, you know, when we spend most of our time, at least I know I do, and I think we do on this program, we spend much of our time here in the New Testament, and especially New Covenant writings after the cross, the epistles from the apostles, the letters that were written to the church by those people who are familiar with the teachings of Jesus and the gospel. And yet, you know what they were using to try to convince people that Jesus was the Christ? There was no New Testament for those people back in those days. They were using the Old Testament scriptures. We would have a hard time doing that today. Why? Because we weren't born under the law. We mm-hmm. weren't part of that culture. We weren't under that covenant. So we would have a harder time doing that. The New Testament pages, especially after the four Gospels, they really begin to reveal, they bring a revelation of what the gospel is, the righteousness of God that we've become in him through his work, not our own, by faith. Grace through faith, right? And yet, Joel, and so having said everything that we've said about our support for the scripture, the Old Testament is filled with the ministry of death, the ministry of condemnation that could not give life. And what's sad is sometimes we in the church world want to dip into those scriptures and somehow try to revise them or read them or look at them in some way so that they can be applied to our lives when they were never meant for that. And that's why you mentioned the word. Jesus is the word, the living word. I've seen people, whether I'm at a funeral or a church service or wherever scripture is being quoted, sometimes they'll go back to that Old Testament and they'll read something. And I've noticed sometimes that they'll change the word law into the word. They'll remove law and use word in place of it. And sometimes they're not always the same thing because we're not under the law. We're not under the Mosaic law and the commandments under an old covenant that is obsolete and has been replaced by something new and better. I'll let you wrap things up here today, Joel.
Yeah, that's really good. It's just the truth. And yeah, without a whole lot of time left, then we hope that you get the picture that we're trying to paint here. To repeat again, we're not against the Bible. We love the Bible. We love the scriptures. We love searching the scriptures. We love finding out about God, about the truth, about everything. But Jesus Christ himself is the way, the truth, and the life. It's him. You can read the Bible front to back, as a lot of people have done over the years, and still not know Jesus, and still not know him, still not know the author, so to speak. You can read the ingredients on the food that you eat and be well acquainted with all of that, but it's not until you actually eat the food. You know, the food is where the substance is. It's the same with the scriptures. It's wonderful to find out about him through the scriptures, but you need to come to him that you may actually have life. All right, that's podcast number 699. Next week, don't know how we got here, but it's podcast number 700. And I think next week we're going to probably share some highlights of past podcasts. So stay tuned for that next week right here on the podcast, Growing in Grace.
This has been Growing in Grace with Mike Kapler and Joel Brueseke. Heard online through various internet sources around the world each week. To access hundreds of past programs, visit graceroots.org. Share it with a friend and listen again next week for more Growing in Grace.